beautiful day in October. It's about 65 in PA. We're going to head to the river and we're going to teach you how to water test jet ski. Basic rule of thumb when doing your idle adjustment, okay? If you turn your idle in, you're opening the butterfly, you're creating more air. You need to match that air with the same amount of fuel. All right, so you have to do that when you turn that idle screw in, you have to turn the low adjusters out just a little bit, okay? We don't wanna be lean at idle. If you are, you're gonna experience a hesitation or fall during takeoff. If you are running a modded engine or you change the jetting, you can't just go off of the manual or what you read online on a forum. So when you do that, you set your low adjuster screws out probably between 1 and 1.5 turns. So when you are creating a smooth idle and you're going to set your idle RPMs, you want to try to set your idle screw kind of on the high end, okay? And then what you're going to do while it's running, you're then going to turn them in, raise the RPMs while it's running, and as soon as you hear the RPMs raise, you're gonna back those low screws out just a little bit. We're gonna take it down to the ramp, we're gonna dip it in the water while it's on the trailer. We wanna warm it up for about a minute or two, turn it off, and then the next time we turn it on, that's when we wanna set our idle set screws so that our RPMs are between 1400 and 1600. Jet size is large enough, so you're going to cruise at about a quarter throttle for about 30 seconds, and then you're going to open up the throttle and go to half throttle and cruise. Then that acceleration from quarter to half should be nice and crisp, smooth. If you hesitate, you need to open up that low screw a little bit. If it takes a while to get to half throttle, that means you're rich. That means it's bogging a little bit, could be sputtering. You may have to lean out that lows to make it a little more smooth. Going to do the same process for the main jet. All right, making sure your main jet is good. You're gonna cruise at 1/2 throttle, and you're gonna accelerate to 3/4 throttle. Again, it needs to be smooth and crisp. If it hesitates, it's lean. If it bogs, it's rich. Okay, anytime you rebuild your carburetors and you use good Mikuni parts, there's no reason you should have a hard start. So I've been running this for the last 15 minutes. I'm gonna press the start button and it starts right back up. All right, so on the 951, adjusting the low speed adjusters are pretty easy. With these 46 millimeter carbs, the low adjusters are gonna be right here. So that's pretty easy, as well as
Here's the idle screw.
Okay, on the 787, adjusting the low adjusters is a lot more difficult because it's on the backside of the carb. So anything that you do, you got to realize how you're oriented. But what you can do is you can still adjust it with this airbox on. You just have to lean in here. You're going to pull the throttle lever, so that carb linkage cable, forward. And then you're going to use your two fingers to do the slight adjustment. So you just have to get in there, get on your chest, reach around and pull that carb linkage cable forward so you can reveal those screws. You know, once you get the hang of that, it's pretty easy. Normally, to check that main pilot jet and to make sure that you're not leaning at wide open throttle, what you're going to do is you're going to do a run for about 30 seconds and you're going to pull the plug. This is called a plug chop. All right. So if you don't have a tachometer, you need to read the plugs. The plugs need to be, you know, mocha brown on the insulator. The electro ground needs to be burnt about halfway up. If it's more, it's a cold plug. If it's less, it's a hot plug. But you also need to see a little bit of, you know, dark fluid around the threads and the flat part of the thread. Good. If you have a tachometer, you're going to check out your tachometer when you're at a wide open throttle pull. And basically, you want to see your RPM stay at the same number. If you start to have RPMs drop at least 10 RPMs every 5 seconds, you're slightly lean. If it drops 10 RPMs at a rate of 2 seconds or less, you are severely lean. If you are losing RPMs at wide open throttle, you can expect a 7/8 throttle seizure in your future, and that's not good. That's basically a new top end.